So this week we have been staying in the Florida Keys, and the campground we've been staying at is easily one of our new favorite campgrounds. So you're going to want to stay tuned and put this campground on your travel bucket list for 2022.
We are Charity, Ben, Dakota, and Trinity. We decided we didn't want to wait for a life of adventure. So in 2017, we bought our first RV and set off to live a life of travel in the USA. We've visited over 38 states in 3 years and have many more to go. Follow along to learn all the best places to see, RV and travel tips, and much more.
So this particular campground in the Florida Keys literally has it all. They have got a campground, they have got a private beach area, they have got a full-on marina. You can bring the powered boat, you can bring the paddle boards, bring your canoes, your kayaks, bring it all here because there is some great water sports to be had in the Florida Keys. Now, where this particular campground is located is in the middle Keys. So you've got like the very tip of the Keys, which is Key Largo, and then you go all the way down into Key West. Well, this is like right smack in the middle, right near Big Pine Key in the Keys. And so this is the perfect place to be because if you want to go up to Isla Mirada and catch a charter to head out and go snorkeling, you can do that very easily. If you want to go up to Marathon and check out all of the fun stuff there and the Dolphin Research Center and things that are in that area, super easy drive. You want to head down into Key West and take in some of the Key West scene? Well, it's only about a 45 to 50 minute drive from here. So this is the perfect place to center yourself in the Florida Keys to have the time of your life in your RV. So now there are several hundred campsites that are here, and probably one of my favorite things about this particular campground is you can actually rent an RV that's already here, already on site, fully equipped and ready to go. So if you're an RV family and maybe you'd like to meet up with family that doesn't RV, well, they can just come down here, drive down here, and use one of the rental RVs for the week, and you guys are all in the same campground, you're all in the same area, ready to just have a ton of fun. So this RV campground is called Sunshine Key RV Resort and Marina, Big Pine Key, but really it's almost like its own key because it is surrounded on almost all sides by water, which means you're set up perfectly for all sorts of fun water activities all week long. And it is beautiful weather down here pretty much year round. So at the time of filming this, we are actually here in December. The weather has been warm and beautiful. In the summertime, it's warmer, but it doesn't feel so bad because being right here on the water, you get a nice ocean breeze coming in off of the ocean, keeps things fairly mild. If you've got AC in your RV, you're gonna be super comfortable here all year round. Now, this is easily one of our kids' favorite campgrounds so far too, because not only do they have a great area for kids to be, from the playground to basketball and volleyball, pickleball, a clubhouse, game room area, but they have got activities that they've got scheduled that are going on that are totally kid friendly. So earlier today, the kids watched a magic show and there was a kid's Christmas party. Just so many activities that are going on for both young and old to be able to have fun. This campground is also super pet friendly. And so while they've got a designated kind of dog walking area, it has just been great taking Alaska for walks every single day. And I just loop around the campground and then up through all of the rows of campers. I've been easily putting in 3 to 4 miles of walking a day just here at the campground. The best part of the rental RVs that they have is they have two different sets, one that is designated as pet friendly and then one that is a no pets. So if somebody does have allergies or something like that, they can rent the ones that are non-pet ones. But if you've got your furry friends that you want to bring along, well, They've got ones that are pet friendly that are available for rent as well. There are bathhouses strategically placed throughout the campground. So if you don't want to shower in your RV, you can use one of the bathhouses like the one behind me here. There's also dumpsters at each bathhouse. There's no trash service, so you just need to come bring your trash to the dumpster as needed. There is also a laundry facility on site as well. So if you don't have a washer dryer unit on board your RV, there are laundry facilities that are here so you can keep your clothes clean during your stay. So this particular campground is a Thousand Trails Encore Park. Now, we know many people that we've run into here that are using their Thousand Trails membership to stay here. We are not Thousand Trails members, but you can still use Thousand Trails Parks. You just pay the going nightly rate that they have. But if you do have that membership with the Encore option, this is one of those that is on that list, and it does run $20 a night with that particular membership. So the nice thing we've enjoyed about this campground is all of the sites are gravel. So when it rains, which we did have a good day of some pretty heavy rain while we were here, the sites weren't flooded, they weren't muddy, they weren't like squish, squish, squish when you go to get out of your RV. Very nice drainage. All of the electrical pedestals are in great shape, and a lot of things here are new because when Hurricane Irma came through, it did damage a lot. And so a lot of the things that are here are new and restored, rehabbed since that hurricane. So it really feels like being at a brand new campground. There are also 6 tiny home cottages that you can rent here as well, fully equipped with everything as far as linens, kitchen utensils, cookware, things of that nature. So in addition to the rental RVs, you've got these cottages that are right on the water that are here behind me that are great for family or friends that are not RVers. So we will put a link in the description below of this particular campground so that you can jump on and make your reservations now, because it is fairly popular. And so if you're considering coming down to the Florida Keys anytime in 2022, well, need to probably jump on that now to check availability and secure your reservation. And who knows, this is our new favorite campground, so maybe we'll just see you down here. So this has easily been one of the most fun weeks that we have had while camping. And my phone is ringing. And it's my daughter. Hello. You are set up perfectly for all sorts. Got off balance there. This, that's awesome, okay. So I'm gonna put a playlist up here for videos about RVing in Florida. And up here, I'll put a playlist of our most popular travel videos. Make sure that you follow us on Instagram over here. We've got some great short videos on Reels for you, and you can subscribe right here. We've got a ton of fun videos coming, and we know you won't wanna miss a single one. If we don't see you on the road or at the campground, we'll see you in the next video.